Okay, Mr. Peter, once again, we're at Tompkins Square Park on a beautiful Sunday, and we're going to talk about things that are new and things that are upcoming. So, a couple of new items. We're starting to get into peppers that are colored because it's been a few months now, and so we start to have some orange bell peppers, red bell peppers. The red ones are already sold out, and this is actually a little bit green and a little bit because the full orange ones have sold. This is a Fresno pepper. It's a little bit hot and it's red, so it's ready to go. Another type of hot pepper is they're called cherry bomb peppers. And these are one of my favorite dishes called something like pollo a diablo. Chicken and the devil or something like that, because it's hot. They use these type of peppers in Italian dishes. The next things that are coming up pretty quick are going to be in the next, hopefully, week, we'll start having a few peanuts and some ginger. And I can't wait for the ginger myself.
Is ginger sensitive to the area, or is it seasonal?
Ginger is a tropical, subtropical crop, yes. It's not something that you find growing in upstate New York very often. But in high tunnels, they can be done, and we've been growing it for about 5 years now, and we get tremendous yields, and it's some of the best ginger I've ever had. In fact, it is the best ginger I ever had. But yeah, it's a bit of a pain to grow, but it's definitely doable. Same with peanuts, not easy to do at all, but we're doing them, and all our chef friends and everybody that likes fresh peanuts are happy. Okay,
so how do you pick a watermelon?
How do you pick a watermelon? Well, there's two ways to pick watermelons. One, by the traditional thumping, which you cannot explain on a video very well, but you get the knack of it after a while. And another way is if they're field melons like these are, you're looking for the yellow circle on the bottom. This is where it rests on the ground, and until this turns yellow, it's not ripe. Now, some of our watermelons, such as this one, actually hangs in a bag on a trellis, and so there is no yellow spot on them. So that yellow spot thing doesn't work all the time. Now, this is a yellow-fleshed watermelon. Okay, so let's talk heirloom tomatoes for a minute. Now, heirloom tomatoes come in a variety of colors, from what is called black, which they're not actually black, but they're dark, as these ones are. And those, even those, come in a bunch of different varieties. And then you have these bicolor ones. Bicolor, because it's got red and it's got yellow. And this is an ox heart type.
What does that mean?
Ox heart, it means it's shaped like a heart.
Oh.
And they call it ox heart.
Okay.
And then you have something that's even got more. It's not a bicolor, but it's a trioco. This one actually has red, orange, and green. And this is actually ripe. This is a ripe tomato. Now, these are the original tomatoes. So these are the tomatoes before we started messing with hybrids. So the red color, your actual red, regular red color tomato, that most of those are hybrids, and this is not the natural color. The natural colors are these, actually. The yellows, the oranges, the pinks. Your heirloom that's an heirloom has got a pinkish color, not a red color to it. Now, these are hard green tomatoes. These are definitely for fried green tomatoes. These are not something you want to put in your salad.
And then these?
Tomatillos. If you're into salsa verde, this is what you make it out of. I like my tomatillos like this, when they're nice and yellow and really ripe, and then they have a real sweetness to them, and you can actually eat them raw. I don't do very often, but they're edible raw for sure.
Which farm are you dealing with?
This farm.
Oh, this farm.
That's where I'm here.
I see only this farm. Market. That's where I get my. That's where I get my food, but my things from the farmer's market in
Union Square. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's all day.
Yeah.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, it's my
years
favorite
ago,
thing.
Years ago, we didn't have it.
I know.
did have it in Manati.
But this is, yeah.
That is so good.
That's my favorite place in the city.
God provides everything to us. So we have to learn it, what? Appreciate it. Yeah?
Yes.
Am I correct?
Yes.
Okay.
This is what I need to
change
learn.
The attitude to gratitude. Be grateful that we have it. Provision.
Amen. These are eggplant?
Yeah, they're eggplant. Wow. They're delicious. You saute them. A little bit garlic, olive oil, and some pepper. This, like, add some a little bit of this here. They call jalapeno.
Mm-hmm. Oh,